Hello everyone, it's Fabrizio from ProHealthics, and today we have another exciting video on nutrition, and we look particularly at the 9 best foods that are high in zinc. So why I picked zinc in first place? Now, zinc is an essential mineral. This means that we cannot manufacture zinc, and we can actually hard store zinc in our body. This is a reason why a daily intake of zinc through our diet is extremely important. Now, zinc is a mineral involved in many biochemical processes. For instance, it is required for the functions of more than 300 enzymes in our body. It is important for the metabolism of many nutrients. It is extremely important when it comes to maintain our immune system healthy. And it's also involved in the regulation of steroid sex hormones within our body, especially when it comes to the production of testosterone. And it also modulates the activity of an enzyme called aromatase that converts testosterone in estrogen. And sometimes if you don't have enough zinc, this can go beyond physiological needs. In other words, if you're trying to optimize your testosterone and maintain your hormone system in balance, zinc needs to be present in your daily diet. Now, the supply of zinc in our diet, as we will see, comes through a large variety of foods. However, the problem with zinc is its bioavailability. In other words, the amount of zinc that we are actually able to absorb through our diet. Now, I found a couple of studies where they have estimated that the bioavailability of zinc is in the range of the 20-30% of the total zinc that we consume. So again, this means that we are able to really absorb only a fraction of the zinc that we consume. So please bear in mind that introducing a zinc-rich food in your diet daily, then it becomes a must. Now, the daily recommended intake of zinc is set for men at 11 milligrams and for women at 8 milligrams. Again, these are just guidelines. The actual level of zinc that you might need might be different depending on basically your level of activity, if you're trying to optimize your hormones, and many other factors that might change the level of zinc that you need on a daily basis. Now, let's look at the foods that are high in zinc. I would like to start this list with meat. Actually, meat is an excellent source of zinc. Now, specifically red meat, which includes beef, lamb, and pork. And to make it in perspective, 100 grams of ground beef contains about 4.8 milligrams of zinc. That is approximately 44% of the daily recommended intake of zinc that we need. Now, of course, now red meat comes also with other additional nutrients. Besides the about 170 calories, it comes with about 20 grams of high quality proteins. It comes with 10 grams of fat, plus vitamin B's, creatine, and of course, iron. Now, I'm not suggesting you then to consume red meat on a daily basis as the only source of zinc. So if you're interested about meat and red meat, try to consume it regularly, maybe throughout the week, maybe a couple of times a week, and go for lean meats. So meats that contain low amount of fat. And with meat, it's important to notice that if you want to optimize the iron absorption, it should come along with vitamin C. So either take some supplementation before eating red meat, or make sure that your dish is also rich in fruit and vegetables that will help the digestion of the meat, absorption of iron, as well as it provide important fibers that are not present in meat. Now, another food I would like to mention is shellfish. A shellfish is healthy, it's low calorie, and contains a great deal of zinc. Just to give you an example, oysters, for instance. If we take 6 medium oysters, you can end up eating about 32 milligrams of zinc. That is a nearly 300% the amount of zinc that is daily recommended. However, like always, too much of a good thing can be a bad thing. So bear in mind that shellfish can also come with some bacteriological infections. So it is important that you know what kind of shellfish you are eating and that you cook the shellfish, especially if you are a pregnant woman. And And sometimes you can have food poisoning depending where these shellfish are grown. And important to understand also whether you have any allergy before you consume shellfish. Now, another one I would like to mention now is on a plant-based, and is legumes. Now, legumes, although they are not very rich in zinc, they provide a certain amount of zinc that can add up to your diet to reach your daily recommended intake. And in this specific case, I'm talking about chickpeas, I'm talking about lentils and beans. Again, to give you some figures, let's say 100 grams of cooked lentils contain about the 12% of the daily recommended intake of zinc, which is not too bad. Also, be aware that legumes contains phytate. Phytate is an anti-nutrient, and actually I have a video specifically made on anti-nutrients that will pop up at the end of this video. Please watch it and you will learn a lot about anti-nutrients. Nevertheless, besides the phytate, legumes are very important, very nutritious. They contain a lot of vitamins, a lot of minerals, including zinc, as I just mentioned, and they contain very important fibers that are critical for your intestine, for your digestion, and for the health of your gut bacteria. Now, another one I would like to mention is nuts. Okay, so eating nuts is very healthy. We know that nuts contain a very powerful nutritional profile, and although they don't contain a lot of zinc. But one more time, if your diet is balanced, nuts will add up to the level of zinc that you need on a daily basis. And for instance, if you're looking for nuts that are the highest in zinc, I would suggest cashew. And 1 ounce of cashew, which is about 28 grams, contain roughly the 15% of the daily recommended intake of zinc. So again, it's a big deal. Not to mention that you need to be aware on the calorie intake of nuts, because nuts are very caloric. So if you're looking after calories, so if calories are part of your diet, the target of your diet, be aware and consume them mindfully to avoid excessive calories that you maybe do not need. Now, another food I would like to mention is eggs. Now, eggs, first of all, is a powerhouse. So basically, eggs contain everything from a nutritional standpoint, from minerals, from vitamins, from antioxidants, and many more. The only thing that maybe eggs are lacking is vitamin C. For the rest, we find basically everything. Now, the level of zinc that we have in one medium egg is about 5% of the daily recommended intake. Again, it's not spectacular, but because of the very high nutritional profile of eggs, I would definitely and strongly recommend to include eggs in your diet. Now, another one that might surprise you, and actually was also surprising to me, is a dark chocolate. So when it comes to dark chocolate, it actually contains a pretty big deal of zinc. First of all, what is dark chocolate? Anything that contains between 70 and 85% of dark chocolate. So I'm not talking about milk type of chocolate bars, because it's more sugar than anything else. I'm really looking at the high end of the chocolate, so 70 to 85%. And what you see is that in 100 grams of dark chocolate, we find about 3.2 milligrams of zinc. That is roughly the 30% of the daily recommended intake. I would like to have just a short notice that the chocolate is very caloric. Be aware that, let's say, 100 grams of chocolate contains about 600 calories. So also that, be mindful on the amount of chocolate that you consume, and even though it's 85% maybe, and there is less sugar, it's still a very highly caloric food. But there are a couple of foods that I would like to mention. So first of all, we have vegetables. Now, vegetables do not contain extraordinary amount of zinc, but yet they might add up to your daily intake of zinc. So to mention something, for instance, to mention a couple of them, we have potatoes, whether it's regular potato or whether it's sweet potato, it doesn't really matter. A medium potato contains about 1 milligram of zinc, which is about 9% of the daily recommended intake. Again, it adds up to your nutrition. Another one is green beans that contains a little bit less zinc, let's say adding up about 3% of the daily recommended intake in 100 grams. Besides the zinc, remember that vegetables should really be part of your diet on a daily basis. And make sure that you consume multiple portions of vegetables every single day. Because they contain not only zinc, but also contain a lot of minerals, other minerals, vitamins, and very important fibers, especially when it comes to reduce, the occurrence of chronic diseases, including cancer, colon cancer, and anything related to the intestine. Now, one more that I would like to mention within, the plant sources of food is whole grains. Now, whole grains, it could be wheat, it could be oatmeal, it could be rice, brown rice, it could be quinoa. Now, to give you some, to put it in perspective, they all contain zinc. They might add up on a variable level between, the 5, the 6, and the 88% of the daily recommended intake. But don't forget that whole grains bring a lot of other important nutrients, such as vitamin Bs, fibers, other minerals, and a bunch of vitamins that you should definitely include on a daily basis. Last but not least, we have dairy. Now, dairy food, like cheese and milk, provide a large spectrum of nutrients. It contains proteins, they contain vitamin D, they contain fat, in part healthy fats, but they also contain zinc. So for instance, 100 grams of cheddar cheese contains about 28% of the daily recommended intake of zinc. Or for instance, a single cup of full-fat milk contains about 9% of the daily recommended intake of zinc. So don't forget that dairy, again, is an important source also of calcium and other nutrients. And overall, it will definitely improve and bring benefits to a balanced diet. So concluding this video, I would like to mention again the zinc, essential mineral that is involved in many important biochemical processes within our body. And the daily recommended intake ranges between 11 milligrams and 8 milligrams from male to female. And it is found in many different foods, whether it is plant-based or animal-based. Remember that before attempting any zinc supplementation, talk to your doctor so that you know exactly how much zinc to take on a daily basis. So avoid self-medication. And be mindful that the highest, the upper limit of zinc that is recommended should not go beyond 40 milligrams a day, because then we have some kind of toxicity might kick in. And remember that very high level of zinc sustained for a very long time, okay, we are talking about 40 milligrams plus, besides having some side effect that will also reduce the amount of copper in your blood and your body in general, and that can cause anemia in long term. So this is it for today. I hope you have learned something about zinc, and you will start introducing these foods on your diet to not only balance zinc but your whole nutritional profile. If you like this video, please thumb up. If you have not subscribed to this channel, please do so. You will help me a lot in growing this channel. And until next time, feel free to write any comment below, and I will make sure to read and react. Stay healthy until next video.